Don't ignore it, Shawnee. You'll be late for school.
Mum, there's a fucking time smell. It's not called school, it's called college.
Whatever you want to call it, Shawnee. It's dead sexy. You need to get you a portfolio and a beret.
Why would I wear a beret? I mean, it's a drama course, not an arts course.
Stop being such a grumpy gums.
I'm fucking grumpy, Mum.
You getting the bus?
Yeah.
Is it going to be a late bus?
I don't know, it's normal time.
An early bus?
About half an hour or something.
Or do you want to go for a ride?
No.
Please.
No, I can't be bothered.
I've been wanking you all week. Wank me.
No, so what?
Please wank me.
No.
Why?
Because I don't want to, I can't be bothered. My mum's downstairs.
Oh, well, just lend me your finger then.
No, use your own filthy
Just
fingers.
put your little finger
No,
in it.
use your own fingers. You've
Why?
got all day.
Put your finger
Get
in me.
off.
I want you to put your Christmas tail in
Oh my
me.
God, that's disgusting.
Britain was known for suffering from the British disease. Now we're known for having the British cure.
Stop bouncing. Stop doing that. Not that toy, please, Lisa. No, you can put that one back. Water all over the floor, about nothing.
Very clever.
Very, very good idea.
He's demanding there, Mum. He wants some of your toast, I think.
Well, he can't have it. He's got some in there.
Has he? Mm. Eat that there.
Yeah.
Mouth. Here, look at this.
Oh, room it in for a little one.
You all right?
Morning, Richie.
You all right, sweetie?
Morning, Mr and Mrs Woodford.
Morning, Jennifer Love.
You know, you can call us by our first names now, you know.
Sorry, I keep forgetting. Morning, Barbara.
Morning, love.
Does that mean she can start calling you Dick now, Dad?
I'll give you a bloody dick.
You bloody won't, dirty bugger. Or a child line. Hey? Huh? The Dick?
I'll give you
Dick. Richie! Oh,
yeah. Oh,
what
a night! Brilliant. That is a bit near the
road. Oh, a bit early for that, isn't it?
So your mum likes it. Mum's laughing.
Just, well, it's because Jennifer's got a sense of humour.
Do you want some toast, Jennifer?
Oh, yes, thank you. Yes.
It's wholemeal.
I hope you like what I've got you for Christmas.
What is it?
Morning.
Morning.
For the love of God, Sanders, will you put some clothes on, man?
Well, I've got nothing to hide.
I can see that, mate.
Sean, don't be rude, love. How's rehearsals going?
Shit.
What do you mean, shit?
I mean, I'm making an idiot of myself in front of everyone. That shit.
How can you be making an idiot of yourself?
Because I can't act. Everyone else is amazing and I'm shit.
Sean, you would not have been given the lead role in a Victorian melodrama if you was bad.
Well, obviously, because I've been given it and I am bad.
Well, you're obviously very good. The teachers have faith in you and I'm proud of you,
Sean. When I go on stage, Gadge and Lol and everyone are going to be laughing.
Well, they're going to be supporting you and if they laugh, it's because they're jealous.
Why would they be jealous that I'm looking like an idiot?
Why are you looking like an idiot? What are you wearing?
Stupid massive wig. Sideburns, top hats, and
well, that's
ridiculous.
Shakespeare, isn't it? You've got to get into character.
No, it's not Shakespeare.
All right, well, what is it then?
It's Tim Taylor or something like that.
Tim Taylor.
So you haven't heard of him?
Well, no, but I don't know my stuff, do I?
Well, neither do I. I don't know what I'm doing.
I think you're just, you know, a bit nervous, that's all.
I'm not nervous at all.
All right, son, I can't really say anything right, can I? I'm trying to help.
You're going to be fine. It's going to be fine.
Whatever, I'm off anyway.
Yeah, well, have a nice day at school.
It's college.
Oh, it's the same thing, Sean. What's wrong with him?
What are you all doing? You don't have to come out every bloody morning.
Neighbours are looking. Get in.
Have a good day.
Yeah, see you in a bit.
Bye.
See you, love.
Get me the fuck out of here. All right.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thanks, Sean.
Hi.
Bobby boy.
How are we
doing,
Sean?
We've got one for Sean. You alright?
Yeah, are you? Good.
I'm knackered.
No, same. Your hair looks nice.
No, thanks. Got up really early today.
What shampoo do you use?
I just used my mum's this morning.
Oh, dear.
Hiya.
Oh, let's go and see Nanny.
Here she is, Nanny.
late. Come on, then. Come and give me a cuddle. Yeah, here she is. Oh, steady with her. Oh, lots of things. All right. Come on, then. Let's get the teapot out. Oh, take that noddy hat off, eh? Oh, that's better.
How do you work this?
Oh, I don't know. How do you make it? Oh, it's only a teapot.
Oh, my God. Oh, he's trapped your finger.
Oh, steady.
Right, go and put them on the bus. Look, over there. That's a good girl.
You feeling all right? You look like shit.
Oh, thanks.
Is she not sleeping?
No. Full time she was last night.
Oh, Lisa, what are we going to do with you, eh? Keeping mummy up all night? Eh? Why don't you leave her with me today? Have a break?
Oh, I've got her at the community nurse at one, so... Sean's got this play on Christmas Eve. I said I'd try and catch it. No. I was wondering if you'd have her for a couple of hours.
What, Christmas Eve?
Yeah, then we can all wake up together.
Yeah, I'd love to. Hey, Lisa, that'd be nice, won't it? At Nanny's on Christmas Eve.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'd love to. I was going to say bingo with Trudy, but I'd much rather have her. Lisa, you going to stay with Nanny on Christmas Eve? Yeah. Wait for Santa.
You're on for a right one, you lads. There you go, Taylor. Sort yourself out with a big bag of whiz, you filthy cunt. Yeah. Give us a smile, I'll give you an extra 10p. Well, on, seriously. I'm fucking about when you get out. Hey, Milner, there you go. Sort yourself out, mate. Davison, sort yourself out. Have a good crimbo. Yeah. Nice one, lads.
You're not getting a bloody bonus. You've not done it. Pull your finger out.
Kenneth Squires. Should be in there.
You having a frigging laugh now? Because I've been through it three times. You've not said no to me.
Oh, one of these. Ricardo, what? You messed up again, eh?
No.
Hey.
Bugger.
Why do you bugger? I knew that. I knew you were
there for a minute. I'm here because I'm a bonus for you. Lad.
Get out. Bloody hell. Oh. We'll wait to that, eh?
Yeah, very generous. Very generous. Check it out.
Knock an arse over, not. Let's have a do.
Bloody hell.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Friggin' hell, it will be. £100 there.
150.
150?
150?
Look at me. Thank you, Mr. Squires. That's
hey,
right, generous.
Hey, I've got more Christmas cheers for you now. So, guess who's been moved up to head office, eh?
Go on.
Me.
You! Unbelievable. Unbelievable, eh?
Hey! Fantastic. Hey? Think of a better bloke for that job, you know. He'll smash that.
I'm part of a new job until he's finding a successor.
Yeah, you're going to get someone in.
Well, I've got one candidate in mind, lad. I'm standing right in front of him.
You can fuck off. Twat.
I wasn't expecting that.
It's a joke. I'm joking with you.
Oh. What, like banter?
Banter. Like, we're, the lads do it all the time.
Hey,
yeah.
Oh,
right.
Well,
great cunt, you.
Yeah.
Aren't
you? Hey, so I'm giving you the chance to step up. Richard Woodford, hey. Manager.
Certain ring to it.
Ring to it!
Hey, brothers from different mothers.
All that there.
No, but listen, seriously, listen, I'll let you know after Crimbo, because I'm going to have a right think on that. It's exciting news. Just going to have a think on it after, and I'll let you know after Crimbo, because you know what, my mum and dad, they're very sensitive.
After Crimbo?
Only because they're sensitive, I've had a rough few months, and they're worried about me, and it just seems like...
Your mum and dad?
Yeah, like common courtesy, just to mention it to them, that they, you know... Just okay with me, mum and dad. They'll be fine with it. They'll want me to do it. You know, I'm fucking overwhelmed. Can't believe that shit.
Yeah. Yeah. You just, you know, a bit less pleased than I was hoping for.
Oh, bloody... No, mate. I'm ecstatic. You're winding me up, you are. Like, down there, like when we were by the computer. Yeah. I'm playing hard to get your being sad, eh? Grin your bit of shit. That were too hard. Too hard. That were too hard, that. Are you all right?
Yeah.
Right, shoved you a bit hard then. Sure.
Yeah.
Didn't mean to.
No.
All right.
No, it's all right. It's all right.
After Crimbo, let you know.
You know, think hard on it.
I will do. Thinking, it's killing me.
Did any of you catch that documentary the other week about the achy balls thing? Oh, it was dead good. It was about this guy who, he had like really horrible achy balls, and I mean he didn't really know what was up with him, sort of thing, and he had achy balls, and one of them went inside of him. Do you know, like, you know when you're cold sometimes and they sort of go a bit hard, and he went inside, even while he was hot, while he was warm, he just...
What channel was it on?
I think it was Channel 4, yeah.
What day was it on?
Sunday or Saturday, one of the... It might have been Saturday.
I watched it. Right, massive, really fat bloke, really sweaty fat bloke. Had problems, walk upstairs and that. Just got himself in a right pickle with anything uphill.
You know,
called Gadget, what is
it? Fuck off, mate.
Gadget. Gadget.
What's
happened to him?
It's hard, this, man. I'm living with this fucking nagging, aching balls all the time.
Go to the doctor and Gadget, you nutcase.
Are you sure you're not twanking too much?
Fuck off, Kel.
Nah, normally, probably with your balls like that. Achy balls is normally fucking...
Cancer.
Yeah.
Fuck off, it's not too young to have cancer. It can't have cancer.
But it happens to the young ones. It's like 14 to 25 or something. That's the most prone. It's all right, we'll get you a trip to Disneyland and you can meet Mickey.
Mate, there's no lumps or anything, man. You can have a feel if you want.
Right.
Come on, if you
I'm
think it's cancer, feel.
Fuck off,
feel.
Get
come
face.
On. It's not gay if you feel
watch
through
out.
The clothes.
Fuck off, man.
Feel
seriously.
Through the clothes.
Get
you're
your
not
fucking balls
out.
I'll smack your face in, mate. Fuck off.
Does she have a feel?
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Fuck off. Milk?
Don't look at him, people. He'll impregnate you. He'll do you with his eyeballs.
You dick. Fuck off.
Sorry.
How is everyone?
All right.
You don't look like you've seen a ghost.
Not seen you in ages, man.
How long has it been? A couple of months?
3 or 4 more, fucking like it.
Really?
Yeah.
Has anyone seen Woods?
Hardly. He's got a new girlfriend.
Fit as fuck she is.
Jennifer. Ginger Jennifer.
Posh.
Very posh.
Son, he deserves it, man. I've written to him, but I've had no response or a reply. I don't deserve one, but...
You'll get there, Milks.
He's like brothers and a relationship like you can't throw away, can you?
Do I get a hug at all? Because fuck me, it's a bit frosty, isn't it?
Good to see you.
Mwah.
Yeah.
Looking good, man.
Yeah.
The girl's in. Out try on him. Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah.
Well, good, good.
Cal, how are you? You right?
Yeah, I meet Titch, she's my girlfriend.
Oh, hello, Titch.
She's my wonderful ale. Less of that, we don't want another black baby on our hands, do we?
Probably around this stage, she could be getting some back teeth. Have you noticed her red cheeks, drooling, fists in the mouth, biting down?
No, the cheeks aren't red. Okay. And, you know, she dribbles and chews on things like any other kid.
Well, that's a good sign, probably, that she is teething.
So what can we do? Because I need to crack this today.
Okay. You could probably give her something like Calpol, and that'll get rid of the pain, take her temperature down and settle her, basically. So if that works, that's the job. That'll put her to sleep at night and you'll have an easier time. It can take a couple of days for it to kick in, for it to work. So you could be looking at another few restless nights, and it can come and go, teething, so she could be okay for a couple of months and then this could start again.
So really, there is no remedy.
It's just par for the course, unfortunately, and this is about the age when the back teeth come in, so that's probably what you're dealing with at the moment, and I know how tough it is.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
You got kids then?
I have.
Yeah. You got a husband?
Yeah.
Well, lucky you, because I don't. Right? I do this all on my own, so you have fucking no idea what it's like.
Can you sleep when she sleeps during the day?
Do you think I don't try? I'm doing the best I can, all right?
Look, she's doing great, and you're doing a great job with her. It looks like you're doing a great job with her. It's you I'm more worried about. The last time you were here, you did seem to be re-experiencing postnatal depression.
Oh, God, here we go again. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
Some sort of fucking psychiatrist now, are you?
It's my job to look out for
her. No, your job is to look after my daughter, right? I came here for her, not for me.
Okay. I know how
I'm up all night, I'm on my own, and you're trying to make out like you've got a clue what I'm going through.
If you ever want to come back and talk to me, I'm here. You can leave Lisa with your mum, maybe, and just
no,
have time.
No, stop trying to organise my life. You can leave Lisa with your mum. You can do this. I'm sure you can. I'm sure it's lovely for you. And do you know what? I envy you.
I absolutely envy every little bit of your life, and I don't even fucking know your name. But I can see that you've got a nice life, and I can see that you've probably had quite a nice upbringing, and you've probably got quite a nice husband, and you've probably got very well-behaved children that sleep at night. I can see what you've got, and you can see what I've got.
I know they seem like worlds apart.
Fucking monotone. That's all I get with you. I know this. I know. Do you know what? I think it's best that I go, and I'll get some Calpol, and we'll leave it there.
When you're ready to come back and talk to me, I will be here for you. Okay.
Okay. In the chair.
Oh, how I wish I was a lass.
I think I see those great clumsy hands spoiling my work.
What bloody hands?
Sorry, sir.
Thank you.
Oh, how I wish I was a lass.
I think I see those great clumsy hands spoiling my work.
Not a chance, mate.
Yes. Don't you remember those two sovereigns you lent me? Count it, there's £20. There'd have been more if you hadn't come so soon.
Bless your heart. And to think these little fingers have been working so hard for such a lusty, big-boned chap like myself. Do not fear, for I have £200 saved up in brass in Portland and Pentonville.
£200? How small my poor little earnings will look.
For the audience, eh? Thank you.
£200? How small my poor little earnings will look. I was so proud of them, too.
Well, keep them, mate. Keep them to buy your wedding gown.
My wedding gown?
That's if you love me.
And that's a wrap. Excellent, excellent, Faye. Dalton, Moss, your scene's up next. I'm just off to the art department to see how the scenery monkeys are coming on with the set.
Did dead good.
You were dead good.
He never said that about me, did he?
I thought you did really well. What are you doing later?
Nothing.
Do you fancy rehearsals at mine?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Okay.
Will you talk to me, please?
Thanks. You open the door. It's freezing.
I've just cut out the bath.
Come on, love. Look, I've got Lisa, Teddy, and got you some money as well.
It's just not a good time.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm freezing. I'm going to have to go. Just, I'm at my mum's tomorrow. Bring it round then.
You can see Lisa when you think of it yourself.
Oh, yeah? Please, love.
I have to go. I'm freezing, milk. See you in a bit.
Come, dry thine eyes, thou art too soft for this life, O thine.
It's a fever, I think, sir.
What are you
doing? Are you sent to mind unkind looks and words, match what?
Smell, what are you doing? It doesn't say do that in the script, does it? Where did that come from?
I like doing the voices.
Yeah, doing the voices, fair enough, but you don't start pulling me hair and hitting me, do you? Listen, thanks for helping me in that, but... You know, you're just doing it a bit too much. I've got to go anyway. I've got to go to Faye's. And I'm going to be doing it all night, aren't I? You know, and I don't want to overlearn it. Can you help me out? Which one of these shirts are, you know, posher?
I think you should wear that one. It makes your neck look less small.
You got a small neck.
You would not believe the day that I have had. Honestly, I said, how can an office run out of staples? Oh. I mean, I said to Janet yesterday, I said to her, if you phone them up before four, you know, they can you can deliver them in the morning, do you know what I mean? But she's not bothered, she's not phoned them up, so then we've come in this morning, no staples.
No staples.
We can't get on without, do you know what I mean? And it's like, she don't listen to me because I'm just a secretary, but I said to her, like, Janet, I'm doing as much as PAs are, you know, and if this were my business, I wouldn't let you run out of things, simple things like staples.
Bloody,
you know,
staples,
I mean?
And everything, yeah. Fuck's sake. It's all right.
Sorry. Hello.
Hey, you sleep. Oh. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. You all right?
Yeah.
You had a good day?
I could, yeah. Lovely, yeah? Falling asleep. I had a right busy one, yeah.
You're not getting out of your work stuff?
Yeah, we're halfway there. Fell asleep.
So, your mum's doing this at special tea tonight.
I know, yeah. I'm looking forward to that, you know. I'd be good, wouldn't
it? Me too.
Got a bit of community spirits, have you? Because you always were such a family person, weren't you? Must be the time of the year, eh? Feeling maternal? Well, I'm shocked. I'm stumped. I'd have thought you were the one person in the world who'd been happy to see me banged up.
It's the best Christmas I've ever had, Dennis. Best present I've ever had.
Ah, Sir Laurence Olivier himself. Well, David Dean, we're absolutely delighted to meet you. Faye's told me all about you. I kneel before you, and all the rest of it.
My mum's told me to bring some beer, so...
That's extremely kind of you. What have we got here? Oh, I say, Hamer's Best Bitter. Now, that looks absolutely sensational. Well, we shall participate in these with delight. Why don't you pop through? We're just about to start our Christmas comestible tray.
1, 2, 2, 2. Sibilance. Sibilance. Am I good? Am I good?
Yes.
Is only half full, so all of you that haven't, make sure you do. I am going to kick off tonight. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Right, a quadra-tray of Christmas treats. There we go. So, we have some mince pies for after, we have Mrs. Dean's sweet trolley, and some savouries. So why don't you tuck into those, because pretzels and peanuts, and these are the fruits. Yes, just put that there. So, yes, help yourself, and, why don't we do one of these? Here we go. Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Mm, lovely. Mmm, absolutely splendid.
Are these, like, funny grapes?
Which ones?
Are they like grapes?
Oh, gosh, no. These are olives. I've never known it before. Right, OK, well, let me just demonstrate to you. These are a... Let me just... There we go. Excuse me. You see that? That's a stone, and it's a dangerous beast, because I remember shattering a wisdom tooth when I was much younger, when I bit down on this.
Crack! Actual stone?
Mm. And if you're not careful, I mean, they look delightful. They look very inviting. And if you sort of throw it in, quack, it can be a rather unpleasant surprise. So, just give it a go. There? It's good, isn't it? Nice. Mm. Tell you what I'll do for you is take one of these. Just excuse my fingers. There we are. I'll give you a little in tray. One, two skews fingers, three skews fingers, four skews fingers, five.
It's
all right, my little darling gosling. Five little Christmas olives. I'm going to help myself with some pretzels. These are very nice. There we go. So, how did you get into the world of acting?
I don't know, really.
The girls.
Oh, the girls, yes.
Wrapped up pretty paper and a big red bag, banged up in there out of the way of decent.
Oh, you know all about it, haven't
you? Decent. The
wife of a convicted criminal. Come on, you'll harm for me. Hey,
Archer.
Room for a little one.
Yeah, go on, come in.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This can't take me both. Oh, I'm just watching EastEnders. Crimbo special.
Oh, my God. Oh, what a night.
Yeah. So how come you're not at the karaoke?
Oh, fuck that. I'm not singing.
No, don't blame you. Shit.
Mm.
Is Kel all right?
Yeah, you know. She'll be pissed by now.
Yep.
Are you all right?
Yeah. So, have you met her yet?
Who?
What is new bird?
Gadget has. Said she's quite nice and posh.
Ugh, God.
Oh, sorry. She's a fat pig.
Don't be daft, you don't need to say that. He deserves to be happy.
Mm.
It's done, me mum. I can't finish it, I can't believe it.
Me too. That was absolutely delicious, Barbara.
Was it all right?
Tired as well, yeah.
It was brilliant.
Mm, thank you.
That was restaurant quality.
Oh, Barbara. You could stop it at all.
Cool.
Yeah. It was Delia's recipe, I just did what she told me.
Right,
where are you off?
I'm just going to like to say a few words.
He's not
one for a fuss, as I'm it is, so I'll keep it short. You.
Oh! Shit, the band, they were wonderful.
Sorry, like, you're going to have to hear me out this time.
All right.
You have been to hell and back in the last 18 months. You've had a rough time. And me and your mum have been very worried about it.
You all right, Dad?
Both me and your mum thought you might never get over what Lorraine and Michael did to you. But as they say, every cloud has a silver lining. And you have found yours
in the wonderful Jennifer. Now, don't get me wrong, son. We've liked every girl you've brought home. But we've never really loved one until now. Jennifer, we thought we may never see our Richard smile again. But you came into his life and a miracle happened. He did.
Oh, really nice, that, Dad. Have you finished? That was it, wasn't it? Cheers.
Cheers.
That, really lovely, that. And I know it weren't easy neither.
Pop, thank you. You know I love you, don't you? Hey?
Great.
You're a great dad. Very lucky. Very lucky to have such a wonderful family around me and all that. And I love yous all. I really mean that. Oh, we're doing this, are we? Hands. Hey? Oh. That were lovely, that, Pop. Thank you. Hey.
£20. How small my poor little earnings will look. I was so proud of them too.
Keep them, mate. It's about you.
Wedding gown.
Oh, for God's sake. What if I forget all these lines tomorrow night?
You will.
Well, if I'm forgetting them now, I'm not going to be able to remember on the stage, am I, when I'm dead nervous? Well,
this is our big scene. Just remember, you're coming back from prison, you're going to ask me to marry you. That's what the scene's about. Just think, I'm going to ask her to marry me and it'll just happen.
Yeah.
Should we do it again?
Yeah.
Okay. £20. How small my poor little earnings will look. I was so proud of them too.
Well, keep them, mate. Keep them to buy your wedding gown.
My wedding gown?
That's if you'll have me. Sorry.
It was me as well. Look, maybe it's just because of the play. We've been spending loads of time together.
Faye, I really, really like you.
I like you as well. You've got a girlfriend, Sean.
What if I didn't have a girlfriend?
I don't know.
Sounds like six.
Six, okay.
Hammer.
Mix. Fix!
Where are you going?
Getting fired out of a cannon.
What's going on, son?
I've got to go to work, Dad. Seriously, Squires has asked me to do a fax. He's got to be in tonight.
I've got to drop the bolt on, son.
I know the bolt's on, Dad, and I'll just take the bloody bolt off. But I've got to go and do it. I've got a big job here. He's giving me this position.
Oh, no, can you just stay for this one? I've got a really good one. Just sit down and stay for this one.
Big in hell. I'm not sitting down. I'm rushing. What? Have you got any words, right?
Yeah. Oh, we've got second word, fix.
Jim will fix it. Is it? Is it Jim? It is Jim. I'll see you in a bit. Brilliant.
Break a leg or whatever it is to say. See ya.
Bye.